The ShakeAlert earthquake early warning system, operated by the U.S. Geological Survey, uses a network of sensors to quickly detect earthquakes and send alerts to other areas before the shaking reaches there. As of 2021, ShakeAlert is now active in California, Oregon, and Washington, where it utilizes a network of seismometers that measure shaking from seismic waves. But work is underway to add GPS stations that can measure movement of the Earth in a different way. GPS, or Global Positioning System satellites, are operated by the United States, but there are also other satellite networks. Many instruments can now use signals from multiple networks at the same time, which is more generally called GNSS for the Global Navigation Satellite System.
In large magnitude earthquakes, GNSS is extremely leveraging to provide magnitude information because seismometers in the near field saturate. Basically, they reach their maximum limit in terms of their observational capability, and once they're saturated, they're not providing any more useful information. Whereas GNSS, we can displace them, you know, several meters and not have any impact on our ability to solve for the position.
This is a brand new GNSS station, recently installed near Nehalem Bay and the town of Manzanita in Oregon.
Basically, we're trying to fill in a GNSS data coverage gap from where we're located here, Manzanita, through the central coast, three sites from Lincoln City down to Florence, and then the furthest site that we installed was northeast of Gold Beach. This one was fairly straightforward because the geology was fairly simple. I mean, we're installing in sand. The construction process basically consists of setting the antenna monument, which is really kind of the critical portion of this, and then setting up our electronics enclosure and its enclosure post, and then tying the two together.
This is our enclosure box for a GPS permanent monument. The core of the box is this receiver here. So this is a Septentrio Polar X5 full GNSS capable receiver. That's what receives the signal from the satellites into the antenna over there. We've got the cell modem here, which is our telemetry. So this basically sends the data back and it gets processed from there. We also actually have onboard processing on this receiver because this is part of the ShakeAlert project. So it's important that we have this instantaneous processing. Of course, the batteries, four batteries, these will keep the station going even without sun and solar panels for at least a month.
So over the last 4 years, we've had two different what we call cooperative agreements with the U.S. Geological Survey. And the first cooperative agreement allowed the USGS and their regional seismic partners, including the Pacific Northwest Seismic Network, to install additional equipment at a number of our stations. In addition to that, the USGS provided funding to upgrade and harden the telecommunications infrastructure, as well as most of the receivers at the original NOAA stations were GPS-only receivers. And so the USGS provided funding to upgrade those to true multi-constellation GNSS receivers. And then lastly, the project allowed us to build five new stations because there was a gap along the Oregon coast when the original Plate Boundary Observatory and the NOAA network was established. This is in particular because 3D displacement in real time is going to be very, very important in determining the location and the magnitude of a large earthquake offshore, what we call Cascadia.
In the event of a large magnitude Cascadia earthquake, fast and accurate warnings will be critical, not just for the shaking hazard, but because of the potential for a dangerous tsunami. Infrastructure like these stations will help make that happen.